buddham sharanam gacchami. That 22 oaths are very, very important. Baba Saba has written wonderful book, Buddha and His Dhamma. That was really Bible for us. And that is my guiding force to lead my ascetic journey in the field of visual art, which is I'm carrying since my childhood till today, and tomorrow I will also carry till my last breath. So I belong to the neo-Buddhist family. It means my grandparents, they embraced Buddhism in 1956 under the guidance of Baba Saheb Ambedkar. That mega event, it brought us for the new culture, that is a neo-Buddhist culture. I grew in that culture, and it got lot of influence on me through my grandmother. So I still remember my fairy tale was all the stories about the Baba Saheb Ambedkar, ki how he struggled, how he's gone, what is his contribution, what labor he has taken for this to upliftment to the society. And that society, once upon a time, they were untouchables. They were from the Mahar community, and they become a neo-Buddhist. This phenomena influenced me a lot, because I was interacting with the neo-Buddhist images in the form of calendar, the form of sculptures, the form of popular imagery. And that imagery impacts me a lot. Even songs, there is a lot of songs.
Ramai mantat Baba Sahibala. Aho thevana bajula dhani hata madhila buka. Karan Baba Sahib abhyas karta. Aho thevana bajula dhani hata madhila buka. Lagali kaho nahi. Lagali kaho nahi ajuni tumala bhuk thevana bajula dhani hata madhila bhuka.
Even family education, because there is Ambedkar Jayanti is there, Buddha Purnima is there, Baba Saheb Mahaparinirvana Day is there. So all these functions also make us, that celebration make me aware about issues, aware about my own society. So this is my journey till today, and it's influenced to my whole academics area. When I enter in the fine art college, so there was lot of aesthetics about that whole aesthetics was the Brahminical aesthetics, but there is no aesthetics for us. Then I thought ki I should do my, I have my own cultural background, I have my own journey, I have my own experience, my direct experience, which that is my direct perception, I can say like this, and that direct perception, it becomes a big resource to pave the way towards to the journey, ascetic journey. My art has a foundation of Buddhist aesthetics. I can say now is the Ambedkarite aesthetics. And my art conveys the non-violence, because we are the Buddhist. And my art has a very unique content which is directly associated with my own experience about the caste. about the discrimination, about the social exclusion, about the social ostracism. Of course, it means the Hindu social order. So that social exclusion gives me the sense of responsibility to I should do through my work of art. I can question, I can reveal through my work of art. Just like I did one of the series called The Untouchability during the Peshwa time in the Pune. The situation was very bad. Untouchable situation was very bad. They has to walk, when they has to walk the street, and that was a shanshan, which Manusmriti talks about this. Keep the earthen pot on their neck and on back there is a broom, because earthen pot for this, he can't spit on the ground because earth will going to pollute it. He had to spit inside of that earthen pot. There is a broom in the backside because they do not want the footprints. The stick with the whistles, gungrus, because they should know the untouchable is coming. If there is a shadow, should not touch him. My identity as the Dalit, I agreed for this. Because of there is a Dalit aesthetics, there is a Dalit literature is there is a Dalit theater is there, Dalit imagery is there. The whole life is Dalit. The society is a Dalit, but I have the very different kind of opinion about the Dalit. Once upon a time we were untouchables, and now we have the power of the rebel, and somebody call us, we are the Dalit. Dalit means strength. Dalit means expression. Dalit means assertion. Suppose I'm calling myself as a Dalit artist, nothing wrong in that. Jai Bhim.